You're good to go.
Okay. So my group had osteoporosis. It's also known as brittle bone disease. And the Oxford Dictionary defined it as a medical condition in which the bones become brittle and fragile from loss of tissue, typically as a result of hormonal changes or deficiency of calcium or vitamin D. Symptoms and assessment. As humans age, bone strength decreases in all people. However, osteoporosis is a disease in which the bones become very weak and become susceptible to breaks. And the Mayo Clinic claims that symptoms do not appear unless the bone loss is great enough to be considered osteoporosis. Some of the signs and symptoms of osteoporosis include back pain caused by collapsed vertebrae, loss in height over time, a stooped posture, a bone that breaks much easier than expected, and fractures that are most common for people with osteoporosis are spinal fractures, specifically vertebral compression, broken hips, and wrists. There are a lot of causes for osteoporosis. Some of those include hormonal, with sex hormones, with age, hormones decrease, and these lower levels weaken the bones. This has a larger impact on women than men because of menopause, and also treatment for prostate cancer and breast cancer have accelerated bone loss because the treatment reduces the level of testosterone and estrogen. Also, thyroid problems. If you have too much of the thyroid hormone, it can cause bone loss. Other glands like the parathyroid and adrenal glands, and then simple lifestyle choices like activity. If you're not very active, if you have more than 2 alcoholic drinks every day, or if you use tobacco. Some more causes is dietary factors. If you have low calcium intake, if you have an eating disorder, gastrointestinal surgery to remove part of your stomach, you can't absorb as much nutrients. If you do steroids or have specific medications, and other diseases like celiac disease, inflammatory bowel disease, kidney or liver disease, cancer, lupus, and many more. Even more causes, there are some unchangeable risks. Females are more susceptible to osteoporosis because of menopause, and they have smaller frames, meaning that they have thinner bones. The older you get, the more likely you are to get osteoporosis. People of Asian and American descent are more likely to get osteoporosis because Asian Americans are more prone to being lactose intolerant, so they have less calcium. And then family history, it can be spread genetically. And then if you have a smaller body frame, that means you have smaller bones and therefore they'll be weaker. So diagnosis, you can do a bone density scan. It measures the bone mineral density. You can perform a x-ray like scan that will measure your T and Z scores. Your T score measures the bone density in comparison to the bone density of the younger population to determine your risk of getting a fracture. And also your Z scores, which measures the bone density in comparison to those of the same age and sex. And then you can also use other tests like bone x-rays, CT scans, and MRIs. So for treatment, you can do some non-medical treatments, such as exercise. If you bear weight on your bones and exercise more, then it will promote the osteoblasts to secrete a matrix for bone formation. If you change your diet to include more calcium and vitamin D, quitting smoking, and if you limit your alcohol use to 1 drink per day for women and 2 for men. And then you can also use some medications. They're written up there, but I'm not going to try and slaughter them because I don't know exactly how to pronounce them. But they're like weekly pills or monthly pills, and then there's some also injections that you can take. You can also take hormones, such as estrogen and mimicking estrogen-like medications, but this is not the preferred way. And osteoporosis medicines work by reducing the rate at which bones break down. So some do so by speeding up the bone building process, and others strengthen the existing bones. Prognosis and follow-up. 25% of people die within the 6 to 12 month range after a hip fracture, and 1,100 people die every month. And a quote that I found, it is reasonable to assess response to therapy at least once after no less than 12 months. More frequent testing might be appropriate in the setting of accelerated bone loss, much as the chronic administration of glucocorticoids. Successful treatment is best determined by lack of fracture, but the surrogate outcome of stability or increase in BMD suggests treatment effectiveness. And then those are my